All right, on page 427, you're going to try 1 through 25 odd today. So on number one, it says simplify. What do you guys, what can we do on number one? All right, 15 and 27 can divide by 3. That would be 5 and 9. What do we do with the x's? X squared divided by x. Right, one of the x's cancels out, but that still leaves one x on top. And then y divided by y cubed.
Y squared on the bottom.
Right, one of the y's cancels out, but that still leaves two y's on the bottom. So there it is. Easy peasy, Japanese. Number three. What can we do on that one? Does this reduce?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Why not? Okay. When there's a plus and minus, you can't just go willy-nilly and start canceling stuff out. Multiply and divide can cancel out, but not addition and divide. So you have to factor first. You should, that, there's kind of a hint in that you can see that it does factor. Have to, but anyway, what can I do to the top to factor it? Take out a 3. If I divide both of those by 3, I get x plus 5. I'm at the bottom. Plus 5s cancel out because there are factors, they're multiply things. So you can divide them away. Equals 3 over x minus 5. Now I didn't ask us to do this, but what x values would not work in this?
5.
5, actually, and negative 5. You really should go off the original. I didn't say that back when we did the Senate, but really it's 5 and negative 5 wouldn't work, even though when you reduce it, yeah, anyway. Number 5. X times 4 over 16, 2x squared plus 6. Somebody's here. What's the odds it's one of ours?
Nope. Awkward.
Somebody didn't.
Oh, okay.
You can like cross cancel also. Is there anything I can factor?
Yeah.
Hint, I'm underlining it now.
Oh, that one. 2x squared plus 6.
What
oh, 2.
Good job, Greg. What can I do with that?
Take the 2
take
out.
Take a 2 out. So, I'll do that real quick. Probably something you should do in your head before you write the problem down. But if I divide both of those by 2, I get x squared plus 3. Now what cancels out?
The 16 and the 4.
Right. Divide those by 4. All right. Anything else?
The 4 and the 2.
4 and the 2. Anything else?
X.
No, it doesn't cancel out.
How could you?
Brady, what are you thinking? Okay, so on the top we have 2x the bottom we have x squared plus 3. Okay, because there's a plus there, that x is not 3 to cancel out.
That wasn't very nice.
Maybe you'll think for yourself next time. Maybe. All right, number 7. Kind of more of the same, just bigger and better. Oh, it does say to set state excluded values. That's okay, we already missed it. All right. Guess what I'm going to do first on 7. Rachel? Factor, okay? Factor so I can cancel out stuff. So on the top left, what goes into 6 that adds up to negative 5?
3 and negative 2.
It's not 6 and 1 because those, you'd have to use negative 6 plus 1, which does not multiply to 6. The bottom is just an x, and then over here, what can I do on the top right?
Taking
x out. And let's see, what's my place? X plus 2. And then on the bottom right, can I do anything to that? No. Now what do I do? We have x minus 2, x plus 2. Do I need a, and nothing on bottom. Do I need to FOIL that?
Maybe.
No, just leave it like that.
Wait, why can't we take out the x and what's wrong
with it? When it's an x plus 3 or something like that, it's you can't like reduce these. But you can reduce those. Multiply, it's basically it's because multiply and divide cancel out, not multiply and add. If it's an x minus 3, you got to think of this as one thing. So all of this cancels out with all of that. But if it's just an x, you can do that like that. Okay, number 9. What can I do on the top left? Guys, what can I do on the top left on number 9?
Take
a 5 out. If I divide both of those by 5, I get x minus 3. On the bottom left, what can I do?
Take a
3x out. And if I divide both of those by 3x, I'm looking at x plus 3. What do we do on a division problem?
Flip
the second one. So the bottom right is going to become the top right, and it's going to become a multiply problem. So it's 3x squared on the top right now, and then x minus 3 on the bottom right. Now what?
Take an x minus 3.
Start crossing stuff out. X minus 3. Anything else? 3. Anything else? How about x squared and x?
That leaves an x.
That'll leave an x on top. So on top I have a 5 and an x, and on the bottom I have an x plus 3. I don't think we did problems that look like number 11 back in the homework. But But 11 is basically the exact same thing as number 9, okay? So even though it looks weird, it's really the same thing as number 9. So 11 is, I'm going to rewrite it as a minus b over 2a divided by a squared minus b squared over 6ab, okay? You guys get it? So it's just like number 9. So really, I could have flipped these in the next multiply. So the left one, you can't really do anything. The right one, since AB goes on top, what's A squared minus B squared? A plus B, A minus B. Square minus square. Okay, now this is actually an easy one. Which one, what cancels out?
A minus B.
What else?
2A.
Okay, the A's cancel out, the 6 and 2 becomes a...
A 3.
A 3. So I got 3B over A plus B.
Did you look out when that guy came in?
No, it was somebody's mom.
Okay.
What guy came in?
There's some guy in there, in the office.
Mr. Zamora?
No, no.
So you can fast forward the video. No, I'm just waiting. Rachel, back to your half conscious state.
Erase that and put 19 on the board.
No, this is full conscious.
No, it's not. Yesterday was full conscious.
Put 19, or add an opinion, put 19 on the board and start writing stuff on it.
Well, I stop at 19, let's go to 21.
Okay.
It's gonna be a lot of work to make it look convincing. Okay, 12 is more like 11. 13 looks a little bit different. Actually, no, I take that back. 12 is an addition problem. You need a common denominator. What do x and y both go into? XY.
XY.
Okay, so what does this need? A Y. If you multiply the bottom times Y, you multiply the top times Y. This needs
an
X. So the bottom becomes Y plus X. Is that the same thing? One's kind of disappear, right? They don't really do anything. Is Y plus X the same thing as X plus Y? Is Y plus X the same thing? Yeah. So when they have a common denominator, you just add the tops together. Now, the order doesn't really matter, but the book will always do it in alphabetical order, so just to keep it aligned with the book. So I've got 2 divided by this. Now it is kind of like number 11. So really, it's like 2 over 1 times, and then just flip the bottom, because you're dividing the bottom. Does that make sense? Is it clear? I just flipped the bottom, just like we did on number 11. I flipped the bottom over. I had to turn 2 into a fraction, but. Is anything reduced on this one?
No.
No. So it's 2xy over x plus y. Celebrate their victory.
Yeah. Okay, what number are we on? 13,
15.
That's
going to
be stuck in your head all day.
Probably. All right. Find the LCM of each pair of expressions. You guys remember these?
What's the LCM?
Least common multiple. It's kind of like the least common denominator. It's what's the smallest thing that they both can go into. And basically, we need to bring all the factors from both into it. That's how we did it. But guess what I'm going to do first on 15?
Factor.
What can I do to factor? What's the first thing I should do to factor 2x squared plus 20x plus 50? Take a 2 out. So I get 2x squared plus 10 plus 25.
Okay, and then we have, after I take the 2 out, I'm left with a 3 term, right? So what goes into 25 that adds up to 10?
5.
5. So those 3 factors make up the first part, the left thing.
Okay, on the right thing we got negative 30. What goes into negative 30 that adds up to negative 1? I'm okay with awkward silence. Alright. So the common denominator, the common multiple, is what do both of these go into? We're going to need all of this. It's not what goes into them, okay? It's what do they go into. So the smallest thing that this can go into is this right here. So we need at least that. But what else do I need for the bottom?
X minus 6.
The X minus 6. I don't need another X plus 5, I already got that, but I do need an X minus 6. Okay, so you just kind of combine everything. If there's a repeat, you don't need it.
So you need 2 X plus
5. Right, the top has 2 X plus 5s, so you need at least 2.
If you guys don't push it, I'd start doing it. Okay, number 17 is in a subtraction problem. So when we're adding and subtracting, we need dividing and subtracting fractions?
Common denominator.
What did both of these go into?
Okay. X plus 1.
X, X plus 1. These are two totally different numbers.
Okay.
It's kind of like a 6 and a 7. If X were 6, this would be a 7, right? So what do 6 and 7 go into? 6 times 7, 42. Anyway, we need both of them. We did need both of them. So this left one, the left denominator, is missing the X. So I do that. And then the right one is missing the X plus 1. So I do that. So I'm not really doing anything on the denominator. I'm already done with that. But the top needs to be simplified. X minus 3x is 2x. And if it does reduce at the end, you should reduce it. Does this reduce at all?
Yeah, no. Matthew.
No, it doesn't. Okay, remember this x is not free because of the minus. 2x minus 3 is like one thing. Let's see. I was gonna say something. Oh, you should make sure that this doesn't factor, because if it did factor, you might be able to cancel something out. But it doesn't. That's it. Number 19, are those two denominators the same?
No.
No, but they are opposites. Okay, when you subtract two numbers backwards, you get the opposite value. So how do I change 2 minus x into x minus 2? If I take a negative out of 2 minus x, I can turn it into x minus 2. Where do I put the negative? In front of that fraction. So 19 I can change into 7x over x minus 2 plus negative x over x minus 2. So the denominators are the same. So I do 7x plus minus x is what?
8x.
No.
7x
squared?
No. Minus.
6x.
6x over...
I didn't see the minus.
X minus 2. Can I do anything with that?
No.
What changes from 19 to 21?
Equals?
Yeah, it's an equation, so we can figure out exactly what x is. 19, you can plug anything into for x, doesn't matter. But 21, because it's an equation, there's something that x has to be to make that equation work. So we're solving for x now, not simplifying. And so the goal really isn't to find a common denominator, it's to get rid of the denominators. You guys remember doing this? So you do still ask, what do all the denominators go into? Since they're all x minus 2, it'd be x minus 2. But whatever the common denominator is, x minus 2, you just multiply everything, all the terms, by x minus 2. Like that. But you don't actually multiply because what?
It cancels.
They just cancel out. And this one it's super easy because it just all the denominators were x minus 2. So basically I just got
rid of all the denominators by multiplying everything by x minus 2. And we have a much simpler equation. X squared plus x plus 2x equals 10. X squared plus 3x. What do we? How do we solve equations when there's an x squared in them?
You take it all on one side.
Move it to one side. So minus the 10 over. And then what? Factor. Or if that fails,
quadratic
formula. Let me see if there's any quadratic formulas. Looks like these all factor. On 20. They only did that like on one problem on the homework. I'm going to forget how to do quadratic formula. So what goes into negative 10 that adds up to 3?
X minus 2, x plus 5.
So what could x be? Negative 5 or 2. There was one other trick on this assignment.
It can't be, it can't be 2.
If it makes the denominator 0, that's a no-no. It's not actually going to work. So yeah, we got to throw away the 2. If you don't do that last step, I have to take a half off, so don't forget.
Do you have to, like, X out the 2, or can you just not put it?
Yeah, you can not put it. So.
Okay.
Alright, you guys remember what I'm trying to do here? Get rid of the denominators. The first step is to find what is the common denominator. How do I find a common denominator with all this mess? Start by factoring. See what goes into all of them and try to figure out what they all go into. So how do I factor this first denominator?
Take a 2 out.
Take a 2 out. Let's divide by 2. 4x is too simple to factor. What can I do on this one?
Take it x out.
Okay, so let's start with the numbers. What are 2 and 4 both going to?
4.
Okay, what else am I going to need? I'll just ask that.
X.
X. Anything else?
X minus 1.
X minus 1. All three of those can go into that, right? Just need one of everything, basically. Okay, so what I'm going to do is actually just multiply all of these by that.
And then you can cancel it out.
Because it'll all cancel out. So on the top, the first one, x minus 1, the 4 and the 2 becomes a 2. And on this part, the 4x cancels out. On this one, the x and x minus 1 cancel out. So I'm left with 3 times 2x on this first one. 3 times 2x, so that's 6x. Plus 5 times x minus 1 equals 7 times 4. three an acceptable answer? Now you could plug these all into the original equation. It would be a lot of work though to check and make sure it's right.
We made it to our goal.
25?
Yeah. You can just stop now.
Yeah. Let's knock it out. 25, that's the largest of the group. Easy peasy. I'm going to start by factoring the denominators. On the left one, okay, these are a little more challenging because there's a number on the front, right? So it's three term, but there's numbers on the front. So what's going to go in the front of my parentheses? On number 25, the first denominator.
3x
and x. What's going to go in the back? What goes into negative 10? 5 and 2, one of them would have to be negative, right? So if I put the negative 2 here, that's minus 6, and the plus 5 here, that's plus 5. That would give me negative 1x, which is what I want for the first denominator. And then on the second one, what goes in the front? 2x and x. What goes in the back? What goes into 6 and we add up to 7. So if I put the 2 and 3 go into 6, if I put the 2 here, that gives me 4. And the 3 here gives me 3. And that adds up to 7. Oh.
It's negative.
It's a negative 7, so I need to switch those to negatives. Yikes. All right. Did I leave myself enough room over here? Probably not. Okay. What goes in the front? What goes into 6? It's either 6 and 1 or 3 and 2. Probably 3 and 2. Actually, they're probably going to repeat some of these, so this is kind of a way you can cheat, because they'll usually use common things in the denominator. So 3x and 2x, my question is, what goes into negative 15? Okay, it's probably going to be 3x plus 5 and 2x minus 3, because they're going to repeat their factors, but plus 5 and minus 3 go into 15. When I do outside and inside, it makes 10 minus 9 is 1, and that is what I wanted. Alright, what do all the denominators go into? Okay. Let's start on the left here. It needs a 3x plus 5, it needs an x minus 2, and it needs a 2x minus 3. Already got that. Alright.
Now you can multiply it up.
Yeah, I don't want to do that. Anyway, the important thing is that everything cancels out except for 2x minus 3 on this one. No way the computer can see this. Everything cancels out except for 3x plus 5 on this one. I guess I'll do that. And everything cancels out except for x minus 2 on this one. Write it bigger there. All right. So, the problem is,
of the one, I just kind of got rid of it. Now we're back to algebra one. So I realize these problems are challenging because they're so big, but when we do get to the test, as long as you can show me some stuff that makes sense, I'll give you as much partial credit as I can, even if you don't get the answer right. But it'll make my job a lot easier if we just got it right.